In today's video, I will be making some confessions. These confessions will be the confessions of a genital piercer.
Show me your genitals. Your genitals.
I thought I would talk about something that's a bit of a taboo subject. I don't know whether it's because people don't want to tell the story or because genital piercings in general are just a taboo subject. Some people want to know about this stuff and I find it super interesting because it's like stuff that you just don't hear about. The amount of people that actually tell people that they have genital piercings is like low already, let alone people who are telling the stories of what is happening in there. I really want to talk about some of the stuff that you just wouldn't know unless you were in that room and you're piercing. Let's just start off right off the bat with something pretty hardcore. First thing I'd like to talk about is the smell. Sometimes you get some smelly little people. I know some people just have an odor and like they can't help that, but you can tell some people just do not clean themselves properly. And that is just not a good time. Majority of people know what they're getting into and they have cleaned before, but that's why a lot of people should be wearing a mask when they're piercing genitals. A lot of people do things differently and it's personal preference to the piercer, but it is a very good idea to wear a mask. The smell can be atrocious. Some people do it for the rush. And by rush, I mean some people do it to turn them on. To get turned on. Some people like genuinely like the feeling of like a needle. I mean, like needle play is a thing. So some people are getting turned on when like, yeah, I don't care what you do. Needle play is a completely different field. Go find a group of people who do that and don't come to a piercer to try and get that experience. Some piercers will literally just stop the piercing and not continue. They don't want a part in getting you off pretty much. Some people, it just happens to, like, they haven't done it on purpose. They haven't gone in there with the intention to get turned on or get aroused or anything like that, but it happens. I'm saying so many arousing words in this right now. It can be from measuring and just getting everything in position. But generally, most of the time, once the tube's inserted into the urethra and you're talking about having this needle shoved through their penis, they lose it pretty quick. Some women orgasm when they get their genitals pierced. I'm coming! Now, this has never happened when I've been piercing someone, but I have heard stories. It's only been a few stories and they have been the VCH piercing. A lot of the time, it is people that you would never expect to be getting a piercing, let alone a genital piercing. So you see a lot of people who look really professional, a lot of teachers, lawyers, that sort of thing. They can't really have piercings anywhere else, so it probably is a perfect piercing for them to be getting. It's just funny because people get judged for having piercings on the outside, but when it can't be seen, what can you do? Just like some people will go and get a haircut or their hair colored to make them feel better, some people will get a dick piercing. Gives them a little bit more confidence, makes them feel a bit more sexy, whatever it is. I just think it's cool. Like, let's not get a haircut, let's get our dick pierced today. Probably one of the most annoying confessions that I can give you is the fact that people are getting exposed and people feel like they should expose their whole life to you then. So it is a very open space. I don't know why, but people just feel like they should give you their whole life story once they're getting their gear off. I don't know you personally, I'm not getting involved, and I don't really care because I'm never gonna see you again. I'll listen and I'll be polite, but why you gotta do that, I don't know. People just think it's time to open up and it's not time to open up. Ever. Let's just not open up to each other. I hope you enjoyed those confessions that I have for you. If you enjoyed this and want some more confessions, I'd totally be down to make another video about this. There is a lot that I could tell you. If you're new here, please subscribe to my channel and give this video a like if you enjoyed it. And I'll be back to see you soon.